Hi guys, we're going to now discuss currency pairs, and we will start with reading a forex quote. Now, as you can see on the screen, we have a forex quote of GBP USD, all right, and there are a couple of important things, that information that this quote gives us, right? So we'll start with the forex quote itself, a currency pair consisting of a base currency and a quote currency, right? With the quote currency is also sometimes called as a counter currency. Now these pairs represent the currencies that you're trading. The first part of the pair is called the base currency, the one on the left, and the second is called the quote currency, right? So in Forex, the base currency represents how much of the quote currency is needed for you to get one unit of the base currency. In this example, GBP is the base currency and US dollar is the quote currency, which you would translate this into meaning that 1 pound is worth 1.2166 US dollars. Now, no matter which currency is the base currency, whether dollar or pound or any other base currency, the base currency is always equal to 1. The quoted amount, 1.2166, is the amount of the quote currency in dollars, which it takes to equal 1 unit of the base currency in pounds. Alright, so it basically means that 1 pound is equal to $1.2166. Currencies which constitute a currency pair are sometimes separated with a slash character, as you can see in this example, right? Now this slash may also be omitted or replaced by a period, a dash, or nothing. So it could just be six characters, six alphabet GBP USD without anything in between also. So this Forex quote, it has two parts to it, a bid and an ask. As you can see on the screen, we have the bid price and the ask price. Now, contrary to what you may be thinking, when you begin exploring the Forex market, the bid price is not the price that you will bid when you want to buy a currency pair. All right. Instead, the two terms are used from the perspective of the Forex broker. So from the broker's perspective, when you are the potential buyer, the broker will ask for a little more than what he might be willing to bid if you were selling. Okay, I know this sounds a little confusing, it actually is not. If you just look at it from the broker's perspective, in this example, since you are interested in buying GBP, the base currency, you will pay the ask price, the broker's asking price, which is 1.2168. And if you were selling, you would accept the broker's bid price, which is 1.2166. If you find these terms initially confusing, it helps remember that the terms bid and ask are from the broker's perspective and not your perspective. When you're buying, you'll pay what the broker is asking for the currency. When you're selling, you will need to accept what the broker is bidding. And the difference that you see between the bid price and the ask price, in this case 2, is called as the spread. So in this case, the spread is 2 pips. It's a difference between the bid price and the ask price. And this spread is just simply the broker's commission on this trade. Let's now understand major currency pairs. So major currency pairs are the ones which now all the major currency pairs contain the US dollar on one side, either on the base side or on the quote side. Now that does not mean that every currency which has a dollar is a major currency. It is just that all major currency pairs have dollar on either on the bid side or the ask side. These currency pairs that we see here on this list, they are the most frequently traded pairs in the Forex market. That's why they call them majors. And the majors generally have the lowest spread and are the most liquid. Now the Euro USD pair is the most traded pair with a daily trade volume of nearly 30% of the entire Forex market. Right, so let me just explain these pairs very quickly. So when you see Euro USD, this currency pair is between the countries Eurozone and the United States. All right, so this is, let's just self-explanatory. USD JPY is US with Japan, GBP USD, the UK with the US, USD CAD, that is the US with Canada, US with Switzerland is USD CHF, Australia against United States is AUD USD, and New Zealand against United States is NZD USD. So these are the major currency pairs which have the maximum traded volume. All right, and generally speaking, the one on the left is the one which is stronger. All right, in most of the cases. Now these are the cross currency pairs. So cross pairs that do not contain the US dollar on either side are known as cross currency pairs, or just in general, technically in the traders language, they are called as crosses. Historically, if we wanted to convert a currency, we would have to first convert the currency into US dollars and then into the currency that we desired. With the introduction of crosses, currency crosses, we no longer have to do this calculation, as all brokers now offer the direct exchange rates. The most active crosses are derived from the three major non-US dollar currency, which are the euro, the pound, and the yen. These currency pairs are also known as miners. So we can see the list of these crosses in front of us. We have euro GBP, euro against Swiss franc, euro against Canadian dollar, euro against Australian dollar, euro against New Zealand dollar, and euro against Japanese yen. Then we have GBP against Japanese yen, GBP against Swiss franc, GBP against Australian dollar, GBP against Canadian dollar. Then we have Swiss franc against Japanese yen, Canadian dollar against Japanese yen, Australian dollar against Japanese yen, and New Zealand dollar against Japanese yen. So as you see, most of these, all these crosses are made from the major non-US dollar currencies, which is basically the combinations of euro, pound, and the Japanese yen. All right. Now the third list that we have is called as the exotic currency pairs. Exotic currency pairs are made up of a currency paired with the currency of an emerging or a strong but smaller economy from a global perspective, such as Hong Kong or Singapore and European countries outside the Eurozone. These pairs are not traded very often as the majors or minors, so often the cost of trading these pairs can be higher than the majors or crosses due to lack of liquidity in these markets. And because of that, we also see that the spreads on these exotic currency pairs are generally quite high. Let me just go through this list for you. It's euro against the Turkish lira, US dollar against Swedish krona, then we have US dollar against the Norwegian krone, the dollar against Danish krone, US dollar against the South African rand, the dollar against the Hong Kong dollar, and the US dollar against the Singapore dollar. Right, so these are the exotic currency pairs. So overall, if you see, we have a list of about 21 currency pairs, which includes the major and the cross currency pairs, which are the most volatile pairs and which give the best trading opportunities. Right, that's it for this session, guys. We'll see you again in the next video. Please share your comments, and I hope you are registering for the live trading session that we're having every month. Hope to see you there this month. Thank you. Bye.